Hello everyone, my name is Vlad. I'm part of Oracle Labs team working on a graph processing system. And today I would like to welcome you into this tutorial where we will learn what kind of useful insights are hidden in the graph data. This is part of a larger set of training topics for Oracle Labs Data Studio and PGX. So in order to understand what kind of useful insights are hidden in the graph data, let us start with a simple example. Let's consider we have an individual set of data points. For example, we have a person, John, 32 years old, living in New York, Bob, 22 years old, coming from Tokyo, and Alice, 42 years old, coming from Paris. In addition to these points, we have a set of cars, BMW, an Audi, and a Lexus. Only having these individual data points, we can ask very simple questions. For example, we can ask what is the age of the youngest person, we can ask what is the most powerful car in this data set, and what is the car with the biggest engine, right? But so by only having individual data points, no connections between them, the set of questions that we can ask is very limited. This also means that the information someone can extract out of these individual data points is limited. Now, in order to boost the amount of information stored in our data, the first thing we need to do is to add connections. And in order to see this, I will illustrate this on the previous example. So let's assume we have our previous set of individual data points, and now we add connections between them. So for example, people, they can own cars, and people, they can be friends of each other. Suddenly, the amount of questions we can ask on this data set is much bigger. For example, one can ask which two friends have the same car, or who owns more than one car, right? So you immediately see, just by adding connections between those data points, the amount of questions that we can ask, one is bigger, second is more interesting. Right. Now, in order to boost this information extraction out of our connections, we need to do something more. So it's not sufficient to just have connections in our data. We need to do something more to be able to make the most out of it. Right. So let's assume we have, again, this initial set of data points. In order to extract the most out of our connections, we need to look at our data as a graph, right? So this means that connections will become edges and individual data points will become vertices. And by looking at connections as edges, we will be able to define intuitive way for traversing them, right? Intuitive ways for traversing the graphs, right? So suddenly, just by looking at my data as a graph and seeing the points and the connections between them as first-class citizens, vertices and edges, I will be able to ask for these kind of interesting shapes on my graph, right? So I will be able to ask, for example, for all triangle of friends who buy the same car type, right? So this is the first pattern that you see here, or I will be able to ask for friends of friends who have more than one car. So immediately, just by looking at your data as a graph, this enables us to ask, to search our data for these interesting patterns, right? So this is basically the true power of the graph. It allows you to follow connections in an intuitive way. And by being able to follow them in intuitive way, you can define complex search patterns on your graph, on your connections, right? In our next tutorials, we will learn how we can map these shapes, like triangle of friends buying the same car, into a high-level language similar to SQL called PGQL, and then how we can execute these queries efficiently on top of our specialized graph processing system called PGX. So thank you all for listening. And I hope to see you all in our next tutorials. Thank you.